Hello, everybody. My name is Vichara, and this is Mega Games Tycoon 2, episode 10 of my Let's Play series. Getting up there now. So we are working on Three Kingdoms 4, Sun Quan's Plan. This is an RPG, obviously a sequel to a fairly decent IP. I forget exactly what the IP value for that one is. Also working on my first console, the Lucera Box. Backup development team is doing an update for Cyberstalker's World. Research team is researching modern 2D block graphics. We will update some engines once that's done. Marketing team is working on a TV ad for the Lucera Box. Once they're done with that, we'll get them to do some stuff for Three Kingdoms 4. But let's let her ride here. See what we get. All right, so that is done. Let's do a update. Is the engine done? Okay, the engine is done. All right, so what kind of game are we going to make next? Research can just bang out some topics. What engine do we need to update first is the question. So we are currently working on a role-playing game. It is the trend, and it's not super saturated. So probably do a strategy game. Have we done a strategy game lately? It's been a bit. It's been a minute since we did a strategy game. We have done a couple platformers, so we don't want to do one of those just yet. So let's make sure the strategy engine is up to date. Actually, it might have been a while since I updated this. It might be up to date by more than just the graphics thing. No, I'm wrong. It's up to date, except for the graphics. But we can add that in there. Stride engine version 1.11. All right, perfect. And okay, so this game's almost done. Question is, do I want to wait for the marketing or not? I mean, I could put it out now. I don't need to wait. It's going to be a minute, right? This is only half done. I need a bigger marketing team, clearly. Commission work, we can do that. I mean, I could get a bigger one. I do have money. I have $34 million. This one's only $9.5 million. But it's getting to the point where I got to start being a little more selective with my space. Because after this one, I think the next cheapest one is $122 million, right? $137 million. That's a lot. Obviously, these are even more. Actually, only $143. That's not as much more as I expected. I guess it's not that. I mean, it looks quite a bit bigger than this, doesn't it? Well, anyway. This one we can buy, though. But so what I could do is I could get a bigger marketing team down here. And then that would allow me to make the graphics studio bigger as well. Because we're at capacity there. I just got to figure out what else do I want to do with this space, right? Eventually, I mean, I'm going to need a bigger development room. I'm going to need a bigger sound room. I'm going to need a bigger research room, right? They all need to be made bigger at some point. But this space is not going to be enough to make them all bigger, right? We got to be very selective with what I use this space for. So I've been putting off buying it, right? All right, so I need to make a decision on this. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to buy this property. Gonna throw in a toilets right here, like so. Furniture, please, and only two toilets fit in there. That's kind of crappy. Get it, crappy. And then we will make a lounge here. Oh, fill that with furniture, please. And then we will do a marketing room. How wide is this? Let's say 2x3. Why does it say 2x? Okay, there we go. By 15. Why did it say? I don't know. That was weird. So it's 15 wide. That's what I was trying to figure out there. So we'll make this one 7. Because we need a hallway. Middle, right? Go like 8x7. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, yeah. And put the door here. That way we can put the cleaning robot there. That is a lot of seats, which is what we were hoping for. Let's get the cleaning robot in. Perfect. And then we're going to take these people that are in customer support right now. And we'll get them to do the pre-release stuff. Right, while the other group can stay on the TV spot. And let's see if there's anybody on the market we can throw in here. There's two people. Question is, are they good? Lucky. Lucky works. And 52.9, that's pretty high base for this point in the game. There's only three of them. So once they're done to this, we'll move all of them down here. Now the question is, do I want to leave the support room as it is? Right? Or do I want to replace that as well? Eventually I'm going to need a bigger support room. But it is not yet. So I think I'll leave it. Now I will need to put some people in there. I can just put two of these people in there once they're done to that. Or I can hire more people, right? Like I can do employee search. Office worker. Skilled worker, efficient, automatic repeat. Perfect. All right, so pre-release of the press went through, right? I can put that out. All right, let's do an update. There is commission work, but let's do an update for the Found Vikings. No, let's do an update for Cyberstalker's World. That is selling extremely well relative to Dug Dig 2 and Found Vikings. Actually, the sales are kind of disappointing on Found Vikings. I guess, did the summer slump just end or something? So sales are not great by any stretch, right? All right, so yes, I can put this in. Probably should have put it out already. But, I mean, maybe it'll be really good now. Hopefully. Yeah, 94 is pretty good. All right, I'm happy with that. That's good. So, strategy game, right, was the plan. So, probably not Satisfactorio 2. It is too early for that. So, do we have another strategy IP? Oh, yeah, Takeover. So, we can do Takeover 3. This will likely be B+. Won't be A, for sure. Subtopic, let's go. This is a conquest game, right? So, you're taking stuff over. Factories, factory fighting over factories. Sure. I mean, it makes no sense, but whatever. Details, right? Details. All right. Strat engine, Qatari to Apple. So arcade, let's just check the dev kits. Right. Oh, personal computer, 14.2 million people. I'm glad I checked. All right. It's personal computers in there. Yeah. That's a lot of people. And there's our modern 2D block graphics. One, everything else we're pros at. All right, and so by the way, this button automatically applied known optimal settings. Did not know that was a thing. Somebody mentioned that in the comments last episode. Thank you for that. I did not realize. So let's put this up and this up and this down and this here. No, we already moved that one. Turn on everything, 11 to 20. So I could make a size B game and cut one thing, right? But I feel like I'm probably past the point of B games, right? Yeah. Yeah, let's now. Well, I'm pretty good at strategy games. Like if this was a genre we were not good at, I would probably cheap out a bit. But we're good at strategy games. Pretty good, decent. Am I good at strategy games? I think so. I feel like I'm at least decent. All right, so let's do that commission work. Everybody's busy. Is there any more valuable research we could be doing right now? Not really. I mean, production, but production needs a lot of space. I don't have a lot of space right now. As long as I have this publisher exclusive contract, I don't feel like I need... production. Oh, speaking of money and publishing, can I buy any subsidiaries yet? I have 24 million in the bank. 24 million, but that would completely bankrupt me. Not really yet. I mean, technically I could buy one. And I could buy them, but I mean, they're only one star. They're a developer. Because you can publish through your subsidiaries, right? You get a big portion. Well, you get almost all the profits, right, when you do it that way. But yeah, I think I need a little more money in the bank before I do that, for sure. Okay, so this marketing team is not doing anything right now. So let's get this last bit of hype for the Loot Share Box. Let's get that up to 100. And then, so this team is looking for more office workers, which is good because we're going to need a couple in here. So once this is done, I'll move them down here. I'll consolidate them. For now, I think separate's probably the way to go. So they're 38.6 through this console, which is okay, I guess. All right, so let's take it off pause. Sorry for the little edit there. I had to deal with something. I try to leave these unedited, you know. People like unedited, at least. Maybe people would prefer edited, but that's probably not going to happen. All right, so let's update the action engine, which this is pretty out of date. And we will go personal computer, because that is going to overtake the Atari pretty soon-ish. We are not finding any office workers right now. At all. I mean, I know it's only a 21% chance, but surely I think we would have got one by now. But no. We have not. So let's hire this extra person. I know they don't have great traits, but I mean, even with these two rooms, I still feel like I need more marketing, because if you got to do pre-release marketing for this, right, we'll do it with these folks once they're done with that. And once again, they didn't find anybody. Unfortunate. All right. Factory fighting. Beta demo. Let's go. And pre-release for the press. Also, let's go. Okay, so they're almost done on the Loot Share Box. Let's do an update for Three Kingdoms 4. Which is selling fine, but like none of my games are getting that next level, right? Although, you know, Game of the Year, Best Soundtrack, Developer of the Year, Publisher of the Year is kind of me as well. I did not get Best Graphics, though. So, you folks, Graphics Studio, you need to step it up. Although I am a prestigious game studio now. And hey, if you like that, if you're enjoying this video, hit that like button. Helps me out a lot as a small YouTuber. So this is ready to go, right? Yeah, because the pre-release of the press and the demo went through. 80 to 100, that's what we want to see, especially for, you know, I wasn't sure if strategy was, you know, if I was at that point with them. 93%, perfect. I mean, at this point, anything over 90 is good, right? Obviously, I'd prefer 95. I mean, I'd prefer 99 or 100, but that's probably not going to happen. So, what else could we do? Skill game, very saturated. We could do another platformer, I guess, or action. I know it's not popular, but it's also not saturated, and we haven't done one for a while. Yet another sequel. And we just updated the end. Like, we could do Biplane Battle. It does have some IP value. Right? Not a lot, but it has some. More than Ninja Knight, anyway. Yes, let's do Biplane Battle, too. Not definitely B+ for this. Action Engine. Yes, please. Atari. PC. Tapple. And Yasuo Arcade. Yeah. Right, nothing else out there. So the NES, oh, the NES is a long ways from coming out. The only other thing is I could put it for my console, but I think my console is still a ways away. Maybe next game I make will be for my console. So I could have just hit this button. All right, so let's look at the letters we got for Biplane Battle. Well, there's a lot of letters here. Story wasn't exciting enough. More beginner friendly, more innovation. So story, beginner, innovation. Well, innovation is in the right place now. Story's in the right place now. Beginner friendliness up. And level design, too innocuous, too easy. Too innocuous, too easy. Level design. So let's move this down. To try that, I guess. I don't know where mission design is supposed to go. Okay. So let's make this the best it can be. Perfect. And here as well. All right, they're doing that. Marketing. So they're almost on a Lucera box. Okay. So let's try to get another ops work. Let's try this again. One more time. We'll move these spokes down when they're done. That'll make it go much faster. Then hopefully I can get more people quickly, right? All right, so let's grab them. And let's take a look here. Let's destroy this. And, oh, I don't care about this carpet. Let's expand this room. We will leave support here for now. Where's the door? Right there. Okay, so now I can throw more people in graphics. I don't need them yet, but I want to have the space. I definitely want to have the space. I got to get some people in this customer support soon. But as they find people, we'll put them there. Care box is at 60%, so it will... Should be done this episode. I guess if I stop pausing anyway, it should be done. Let's do some commission work here. What kind of game am I going to make next? Do I need to update an engine? All right, so Three Kingdoms 4 is selling pretty well there now. But yeah, I feel like I need a breakthrough hit. I mean, oh, Bifling Battle got a bunch of extra bugs. That's fine. Fourth fantasy off the market, so we can make fifth fantasy now. Right, maybe that's what I should do next. Sports game. Okay, so let's get the unrepeatable quests. Let's get those. Wow, there's a bunch of gameplay features. When did these come through? Hey, we finally got somebody. So they get sick a lot. Stress averse is fine. I don't care about stress averse. Speaking of which, did I ever change my employee settings? I don't think I did. So I typically put this... So crunch time means... Once the whatever they're working on is 90% done, they're not allowed to take breaks anymore, right? So I usually put this up to 95, so that's more employee friendly. Motivation recharge, usually put this up to 50. So this means once their motivation gets down to 50, they go on breaks. So they go on breaks slightly more often, but they don't get as cranky, right? So yeah, I usually do those much earlier. I kind of forgot this run. That's okay. Oh my god, this game's ready almost. Got to do the pre-release stuff here. Okay, there's another person. All right, so we got two people in here. That should be good for now. So, special marketing. Where are you at? Biplane Battle 2. Release beta demo. And pre-release for the press. They get through these pretty quick now. There's so many people in here. Let's continue development, though. Let's let this happen. Let's look for a couple more office workers while we can. Okay, plus 7 hype, plus 3% review score. Up here, let's make sure this engine is up to date, my RBG engine. I feel like it needs the graphics, but it has everything else, yes. So let's just wait for them to finish that, and then we'll put this game out, but it's going pretty quick. Actually, oh no, never mind. Efficient and lucky? Yes, please. All right, so they got through all those features. Oh, we got sports and simulation. Okay, so we'll do those. Right now, we're going to put this game out, and we're going to do fourth or fifth or whatever fantasy we're at. Fifth fantasy, I think. Yeah, I think we're fifth fantasy. Only 70 to 90. I think it'll actually be over 90, though. I'm hoping, anyway. Certainly hoping. Yeah, 88 is... Oh, 88's fine. I'm okay with 88. Again, I'm not thrilled with 88. So I think I'm going to put this game for my console. This will be like a launch title, this fifth fantasy. Where are we at? Fourth fantasy. Boom, B plus, yes, role playing game, perfect. What's our IP value on this? Oh, it's still not very high. I don't know, maybe this will be the one. Maybe this will be the one to push it to the limit. PC, yeah, PC overtook Atari, Tapple, Mr. Arcade. Getting better with those graphics already. Okay, let's make sure everything's where it's supposed to be. It is perfect. I'm gonna actually go like this. I feel like last RPG, my gameplay wasn't that good. 16 things all apply, some of which are green. Random story events, repeatable quests, those are new, so that'll help. This is gonna be a good game. I have faith that this is going to be 95%, I think. I really honestly believe that. Am I correct? Maybe, maybe not. Man, there's a lot of commission work here and game reports. But I want to focus on this game. I want to get this stuff done sooner because that means bug fixing is done sooner, which means polishing starts sooner, right? So as soon as, okay, so as soon as this sim is done, we'll do a engine for that. In the meantime, got a couple of games here that have not had updates, free updates at all. So let's do that. All right, we got case for handheld. I forgot to put it for my console. Because I'm dumb. And let's do... I can't believe we did that. No, I mean, I can believe I did that. But I'm upset with myself that I did that. But I can believe it. Sigh. Well, they're both selling well, though. Those two newer game, new-ish games. Efficient, but a couple negative trends. Yeah, I'll throw them up here. Support. All right, so they're good with the support queue. Let's get some extra fans. Get over 100,000 fans here. And we'll end automation here and start the pre-release professional marketing. I'm assuming, yeah. I was like, I'm assuming it's already at least 50 hype, and it is. I probably could start doing TV spots for these games, right? But anyway, let's continue development for now. We got a couple things we gotta bang out here. Sound team is still working. Graphics team is still working. Okay, they're polishing now. They're polishing. Okay, so that's simulation. Simulation's done. So let's get a engine for sim. Just include the best stuff, obviously. Simulation, personal computer, call this sim engine. Yeah, 5%, let's go. And if you want it, you're gonna pay me 100,000 if you want this engine. It's that simple. Yeah, I wish I would have put this for my console because my console is ready. Sigh. Whoops. I mean, I can port it to my console. Maybe that'll be worth it. Plus, I believe porting a game gets me an achievement, I want to say. Think? Maybe? 94. I was close. I said it'd be 95. All right, so console is done. All right, hopefully it's good. Hopefully, all right, so we're going to hold at a $15 profit. So yeah, so you set the price. Your profit is based off your production costs. Production costs go down over time, right? So by clicking this button, you hold the price at $15 profit. So as production costs go down, price of the console goes down. We always make $15 on a console sale, basically. And I was going to say, I was hoping for at least 8 out of 10. Didn't quite get it, but we were close. All right, so how close are we to making handheld? I could make a handheld. Should I make a handheld? Let me know in the comments, folks. What do you think? Should I make a handheld? All right, port a game. Fifth Fantasy. We can't. Crap. Well, I screwed that up. All right, so now I can make a game for that, my console, though. Make a sim game, I guess, since we got the engine, right? Completely unsaturated. Call this old Loot Flight Sim. And yes, this is definitely a combination I've used before and I will probably use again. I don't apologize for that. Probably adults for this, I would say. Sim engine, PC, Atari, Apple II, and there's like 45 million, 26 million, 23 million. Giant drop off to 2.7 million. So I don't even feel bad for putting it on my console instead, right? Don't even feel bad whatsoever. Oh God, for this. Ori down, character design down, level design, mission design up, innovation up. Game depth up, length down, core. God, I don't even know. Try that. Doubt that's right. 14 out of 20. Okay, perfect. Probably. I mean, it might have been better cutting features and making this smaller because it's my first one. Again, as long as it's over 70%, I'm okay with it because that gets us the achievement, right? So they're still working on sports game. Let's blast through this commission work. And we're going to need to hype this up because it's a brand new IP. But we'll be able to do that very quickly with this larger marketing team, right? Oh, we got some new cartridge or new console stuff coming through. So let's take a look at that once sports game is done. And maybe once we get that, we can do a handheld, right? All right, so actually, you know what? That's going to be all for this episode. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit that like button. Subscribe if you haven't already. Join my Discord. Consider supporting me on Patreon. Check out my main channel. Links in the description down below to all of those. Most importantly, be good to each other. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.